Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of PHP, that is PHP version 8.3.6 on the Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how we can easily create a simple Hello World PHP program and how to run that on our console. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you will be learning a lot of new things. And after watching the video, if you still face any issues, you can always comment in your comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install the latest version of PHP, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to just simply search over here PHP download and hit enter. And immediately you'll be able to see this www.php.net as a first search result. So you click on this download and it's going to redirect to the official site of PHP. So this link php.net/download.php link I'm going to provide right in our description. So you can directly use that link from our description to land over here. And once you are here, you'll be able to see that our Windows download link over here. So we are downloading it for Windows. So we are going to click on this Windows download and it's going to again redirect to this latest PHP version 8.3, that is 8.3.6, page. Alright, so here you can see we have a non-thread safe and another is a thread safe. So you need to proceed with the thread safe. So under thread safe, you'll be able to see a zip over here. So you need to click on that zip and immediately you'll be able to see that our PHP started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and here you can see that same zip file PHP 8.3.6 is already been downloaded over here. You need to just simply right click and to click on extract all to extract this zip folder onto our this directory. So you can see that it is properly extracted and these are all the files. Let's just close this file. So here if you go inside that folder, you can see all files and folders are rightly over here. Right, so what you need to do is after extracting, you need to right click and to click on the show more options and then to click on this rename. So what we want is we want to rename this folder to something like PHP 8.3.6 only. Alright, so something, you know, short. So after that I'm going to cut the folder. I'll go to my C drive and I'm going to paste this folder simply over here. So you can see our folder is rightly pasted over here. And now what you need to do is you need to go inside this folder and then you need to copy this path. So just simply right click and copy this path, then minimize this folder, go to search again and this time just simply type environ. You will get this editor system environment variables. Open that and click on environment variables over here and then you need to click on path over here. So just click on edit, so that will open this edit the environment variable window. Just simply click on new, then right click and paste that, you know, PHP path over here, then click on OK, then again OK, and then again OK. And now if you go to search again and type cmd, it will show you this command prompt. Open the command prompt and within command prompt, if you just simply type php space dash dash version and hit enter, you can see that the latest version of PHP version 8.3.6 is rightly shown on our console. So if you see this similar type of message, then all that basically mean is our PHP is successfully installed. So it's time to write some code. So go to new and create a new folder and give the folder name as PHP practice and just simply go inside that folder. Let's create a new text document. So I'm going to give the next text document as prog1.php. So I'm going to remove this .txt with .php extension. So just click on outside. Do you want to change the file name extension? Yes. So you can see that our prog1.php file name extension is properly created. If you don't able to see this type of file name extension, what you need to do is you need to go to view and then you need to hover over show and then you need to enable this file name extensions. Alright, once we enable this file name extension, we'll be able to see this .php or .txt. Or if you have watched my Java video, there I have showed you how to, you know, make a .java file. So that is what you need to do. You need to enable from view, you need to enable these file name extensions and then you'll be able to see this prog1.php over here. Alright, so now you need to open this file. Simply just simply right click and, you know, open this file with notepad. And on our notepad, I'm going to write a simple Hello World code snippet. So I'm going to give angular bracket PHP, and I'm going to close this angular bracket, and within, you know, our this PHP tag, I'm going to just simply go hello world. So if I just simply write hello world, and I go to file and save this file, and after that I need to go to this address bar again. I need to type cmd to open our command prompt right at this location. So under PHP practice folder, you can see our command prompt is rightly open. So we need to run this program, right? So what you need to do is you need to just simply type php and then your file name, which is prog1.php. So prog1.php, and hit enter, and you'll be able to see the output and world, whatever you have written on your code, that is over here, whatever you have written is properly shown on our console. So if you edit this file, so like after hello world, let's say you have given a couple of exclamation marks. So after hello world, couple of exclamation mark, you go to file and save this file. And now if we again go to your console and rerun the same file all over again, this time you can see, you know, hello world is properly shown on our console. So you need to just simply on your keyboard, just you need to press that upward key. If you kind of press that upward key, you'll get that, you know, last time whatever you have written. So that same thing will be showing over here. So hit enter, you'll be able to see the output, right? So in this way, you can easily install latest version of PHP. You can write some code, you can write your programs, whatever you might have got from your school or college, some PHP assignments, you can immediately start. But one thing I want to mention over here, that as PHP is a server-side language, so generally we use a product called XAMPP. So if I go to browser again and type XAMPP, you know, you'll be able to see this XAMPP installer. Open that, and this is what we, you know, commonly use for PHP. Here also you can see like PHP MariaDB Perl. So for PHP we use a server called XAMPP. All right, so I have already made a detailed video about XAMPP, so please do follow that video to learn about XAMPP, how to install XAMPP, how to write code on PHP, all of that. Also, if you go to our channel, you'll be able to see this playlist, popular playlist, that is this one. So here, if you see, we have created a complete tutorial about WordPress. Again, we have used XAMPP, so we created a local environment, and within that local environment, we have, you know, installed WordPress, then all these different themes, then we have developed a gym website, and after that, we have deployed that to Cloudways. So you can follow this entire playlist. I highly recommend you to follow this playlist as well to know how to create a WordPress website, and everything will be completely free of cost. All right, so you can watch this tutorial to learn about how to create WordPress and all. And also I have started Geeky Syntax channel, so here regularly I am posting coding related videos, so please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel as well. And also if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. All right, totally your wish. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.